Gives this woman to this man with great happiness.
Yeah, you have to give her to
him. Yeah, there you go. Please have a seat. I'd like to welcome you here this afternoon on behalf of Matt and Lynn. And those of you that are visiting San Diego, and you're not here a lot, the weather is not always like this. Sometimes we have sunny days, okay? All right? So we're thankful that you're here. It's going to be an intimate, close service, and that should mean something special to each of you that are here participating and days. Let's go ahead and open up the word of prayer. God, we are thankful for your many blessings. And particularly today, we're thankful for the blessing of Matt and Lynn, that they met each other, that you've drawn them close together, and that they're here today to celebrate their relationship and to enter into a marriage. We ask for your continued watch care over them, and we thank you for your goodness too. Amen. Matt. Now, before God, and in the presence of these witnesses, will you, Matt, take Lynn to be your wedded wife? Will you love and comfort her, honor her and keep her, and in joy and sorrow preserve this union, holy and unbroken, until death shall separate you? Lynn, before God, and in the presence of these witnesses, will you, Lynn, take Matt to be your wedded husband? Will you love and comfort her, honor her and keep her, and in joy and sorrow preserve this union, holy and unbroken, until death shall separate you? This is the time of the service where I do the thing called the charge. And what the charge is I say a couple of things, typically about marriage, hopefully to encourage you. Hopefully to, some words that I'm going to share some words from Scripture. But there are two things I'm going to share today. The first is a cautionary note. I know that I'm verbalizing what many of us are feeling, that you guys are very impulsive, running into this wedding after only knowing each other for a decade, right? And I really think that you guys should learn to slow down a little bit and think these things through before you do it, right? Okay? That's the first. The second is a little on a little more serious note. You know, some time ago I was at the Kobe Swap Meet, and I was there looking at some antique books that were for sale. There's a booth there, and so I was there looking at these books, and while I was there, not many people there. There was a woman there as well, and we were kind of looking at the same books. There were only a couple of bookshelves there. And we kind of struck up a conversation as we were standing right together. And she picked a book up off the shelf, and it was Victor Hugo's Toilers of the Sea. And I love that book. And so when she picked that book up, I said, "Oh, that's a great book." And she said, "Really?" And I said, "Absolutely, I love it." She said, "Well, what's it about?" And I said, "Well, it's kind of a love story." And so she took the book down and she opened it up to the middle and she read a page. And it was just a page in a story. And she turned to me and she said, "This doesn't sound like a love story." And I said, "It's a love story, not a romance. You're mixing them up." And she said, "Well, what's the difference?" Well, I'm going to tell you the difference between romance and love. The Apostle Paul, writing to the Ephesians, is encouraging them, telling them how they should care for each other, and it's appropriate for a wedding.